A year ago, Morgan Shepherd led this race. He has led it today. He finished 13th. He said it was that win.
Oh,
that
out of control goes Kenseth.
And over on his roof.
Get back on the wheels.
A wild ride for the Daytona 500 winner, Matt Kenseth.
You see Matt moving in there. You can see him trying to get the window net down. There he comes out.
Coming out. That's good to see. That was Katie Kenseth, his wife there. That's a scary moment for anybody. Definitely a scary moment for Matt.
See Matt a little bit frustrated, angry.
Didn't see exactly what caused that. We just saw him kind of bounce out of line there.
Just know at this time of the race that the guys are going to start giving less and
taking
bumping
more.
Harder. And all it takes is just a little bit there when you're in the middle and no saving. Just a testament to the safety of these cars, too, that can take a lick like that. We're seeing Matt's in second place right here behind Ryan Newman. See what happens. He goes to block.
Comes back in line. It looks like he may get a tap. Yeah, he gets a tap from David Reagan.
Yep.
Car gets out of shape and then just pirouettes on its left side and goes over.
And we talk about the bump drafting has to be done on the straightaway. And you can see, even on the straightaway, if you get hit too hard, it just takes the steering wheel out of your hands as a driver.
This was the scary part right here when he's on his roof for so long. Looked for a minute like he might save it, but then got down there. Golly, this is tough.
Yeah, and Matt really did a great job. If he goes up in front, he takes out 15 or 18 cars. So he did a great job of not creating that situation.
Let's see what Dale Earnhardt Jr. saw here as the contact took place right in front of him.
So everybody jockeying for position here. Oh, Matt gets a shove.
Three wide.
Damage actually on the left rear of the 18.
Breaking down low. You're clear right there. Clear all around. They wreck behind.
John West Townley going by. You see, he sees Kenseth's car just rolling over side by side.
And you could see in that last shot from Dale Jr.'s that it literally lift the back of the car off the ground whenever David Reagan.
Yeah, you see the back end come off the ground on the 16. There's just no way to control that. It's a strange way to see one flip. You don't normally see them do that.
No, but these cars have a liftoff point of getting off the ground of about 170 miles an hour. And no matter, even with all these safety innovations that NASCAR has put into these cars, you still, these cars get in that right situation or wrong situation.
They have to get in the perfect spot, yeah.
Second time in 3 years we've seen a car go on its roof here. 2 years ago, it was Kyle Busch who had a violent rollover down the back straightaway. And now this year, it is another veteran in Matt Kenseth and the 18 car on pit road.
He had a lot of damage to that left rear, so they had to fix that and see him still working on it. He was the only car coming down pit road for service.
Yeah, I said it a while ago, as bad as this is for Matt Kenseth, he did a terrific job not to create a really huge accident.
Ryan Newman had come from 19th on the restart all the way back up front to lead it, but that's what was going on right behind him. As the contact between a couple of Roush Fenway teammates sends the 16 over on its roof. Fortunately, Matt Kenseth able to walk away. Back to the green in just a moment.
Moments ago, Matt Kenseth flipped multiple times. He has escaped, and you have a smile on your face. Matt, what do you recall moments before you were flipping?
Well, first of all, I'm always smiling because I landed right side up. So that's the only reason I'm smiling. Kyle had a run, and I tried to block the top, but I couldn't get up there in time. And I pulled to the bottom. I saw David there, but I was well clear. And, David hit me as I was turning back down in there to bum draft me. You just can't hit somebody when they're turning. The cars aren't just stable enough for that. So I felt David hit me, and then the car just spun out. And then really, I was just hanging on, hoping I ended up right side up.
Your boss, Jack Roush, walking in now. We're getting ready for the restart. So the six car, a little aggressive on that?
Well, I mean, everybody's shoving and pushing it then. There, he actually pulled to the bottom, and he was hitting me real hard to try to, you know, help me and give me position. So I don't know. I know I was clear, and I pulled in front of him, and he just hit me square from the back. But, you know, when a car's switching lanes, just can't run in the back of them. They're going to spin out.
Big sigh of relief. His wife, Katie Kenseth, very pregnant. She's here with her man, Matt Kenseth, and he's okay. Doc.
Thanks, Jamie. Glad to see Matt okay. A little frustrated, but understandable after you tumble there at 190 plus miles an hour. Well, inside.